show part of another one. And you know, you have to do that. You have to stop for a second and turn the light on. And an older viewer said to his companion, as I was changing, said, "Well, I'm ready to go anytime you are." You know, the whole room could hear. And so I thought it was funny, but I thought, okay, try to keep it to one carousel. So I'll try not to show you more than one carousel total, but we are gonna change. Okay, these are all, I think you'll enjoy seeing the natural setting here. These are all taken in 2015. If I'm standing in anybody's way, just tell me. Okay, so this is, here's the depot. This was the end of March, the end of February 2015. Maybe I'll pull up a chair here so I feel like I'm going to block people. Anyway, there's obviously been a pretty serious snowstorm. Look at the cars there that are local folks that just parked and are going to wait for it to melt. Okay, so here comes a train of westbound empty coal hoppers. This was a pretty busy afternoon. I put on my note there. You know, if you ask me how many trains a day, I don't know, maybe 15. It comes up and down, goes up and down. Other than coal traffic, in season there are some grain trains. There's only one. You know what a railroad would call a mixed freight, meaning boxcars and you know other loose carloads. There's only one a day. This is as I say, it's primarily a coal route. So looking west. Okay, here's at the west end of Prince. The main line to follow the river. The river actually makes a super sharp turn, and so the railroad doesn't do that. It bores through a mountain and basically eliminates this sharp turn on the street. So this is called Stretcher's Neck Tunnel. And I don't know where that name came from. You can tell it was double track. And this sort of the bad days of American railroading were probably in the 70s when a lot of financial stresses that had been brewing for a long time kind of came to a head. And the industry was very much in a mode of retrenchment, and they did a lot of track removal. And then in the 80s, traffic started. There was a deregulation bill in 1980, actually sponsored by West Virginia Congressman Harley Staggers. And you know, at first, I don't think people paid a lot of attention to it, but it was actually a pivotal bill that allowed the industry much more freedom to offer competitive rates. And that's the thing that really led to traffic coming back and growing. So in some cases, railroads were sorry they took up track. Here, it's not an issue. They have enough capacity. Okay, here, Prince is down. I should get out my pointer here as I'm talking. Let's see, where did I go? So Prince is back here. Valley. Quinnamont, we'll see a couple shots. Quinnamont is around the curve here. This is a coal branch that goes over the New River. The river, of course, is right down here. Yeah, I looked up on my introduction there. It said Prince in the last census, 2010, there were 160 people that lived there. So the interesting, they have a post office. It's open every business day. There's literally, as a friend of mine lives there, a retired coal miner, he and his wife live there, and you know, he said, you can't buy a Coke in Prince. In other words, there's no store of any sort. Everybody, for services, they simply have to drive to Beckley, which is about 12 miles away. But there's a good bridge over the river. It would it's such a beautiful area. I don't think it would be a hardship to supply yourself in Prince. Notice these are, speaking of this Art Deco style, those are three-dimensional metal letters there. You'll see the station building itself here in a minute. So the mountain in the background, and again, curving around Quinnamont, this is looking east. Quinnamont. eastbound loaded coal train. So I've talked about how following the stream means that the grades are less. Because it goes through that tunnel, there's a little bit of a grade right here. In other words, it's not exactly on the river course. And yeah, the grade through the tunnel is something like, what was it, 0.4% for an eastbound train. Of course, the river's flowing west towards Gauley, where it joins with the Gauley River and forms the Kanawha, which then flows through Charleston and then flows into the Ohio, right? So by definition, as you come upstream, there's a grade, and you know, 0.4% is certainly not a heavy grade by any stretch of the imagination for a railroad. However, for a heavy train like a loaded coal train, it's noticeable. And so a train like this is, you know, even though it has modern locomotives, a train like that is working. Coal hoppers, there were some that were kind of new there, that took a shot up. Coal hoppers in the last 60 years, 65 years, have literally doubled in capacity. These are all like probably 110 or 120 ton coal hoppers, meaning low capacity. And if you went back to the 1950s, the standard was a 50 ton and then a 70 ton hopper. As I say, literally doubled in size. So here comes another train of westbound empty hoppers under the cantilever signal bridge. Notice there's signals in both directions. These are the two main tracks right here. It goes to single track, it goes through the tunnel. This is basically a yard lead, a siding between Prince and Quinnamont. So the signals are for the two main tracks in both directions. The CNO is very progressive about installing what a railroad would call reverse signaling, meaning trains can run both directions on both tracks, rather than one track signaled each way. And, you know, I see that and I think it's really too bad they single tracked, because all they did was reduce capacity. But anyway, that's the way it goes. Let's see, I want to show you here. There's a side view. So now coming out of the tunnel, here comes an eastbound train with some non-CSX locomotive, a locomotive that they're leasing from some company. Yeah, I don't, there's quite a few of these operations that maintain locomotives that railroads can lease for extra power. This is the one daily mixed freight, which is basically a long distance local from Russell, Kentucky on the south shore of the Ohio River to Richmond, Virginia. And that is to say, that's the only mixed freight on the line every day. Where is the CNO? There you go. So there's the backside of the station. And notice the big CNO emblem there in the shadow. I'll show, when I change carousels, I'll show you something. Oh, okay, yeah, this is a couple of nice views. I'll show you something about that CNO emblem on your handout. So looking east, there's the signal bridge down there. Notice there's still a Coke sign from some pool room